And now, ladies and gentlemen, the Metropolitan Room is proud to present the tall and short of it. Here are Paul Binder and Dana Mierlak.
Good evening. I'm Paul, the tall one.
Dana, average in stature.
Oh, we ain't got a barrel of money. Maybe we're ragged and funny, but we'll travel along, singing a song, side by side. Oh, we don't know what's coming tomorrow. Maybe it's trouble and sorrow, but we'll travel the road, sharing our load, side by side.
Through all kinds of weather, what if the sky should fall? Just as long as we're together, it really doesn't matter at all.
Doesn't matter at all. When they've all had their troubles and parted, we'll be the same as we started, just traveling along, singing a song, side by side.
Through all kinds of weather, what if the sky should fall? Just as long as we're together, it really doesn't matter,
at all. When they've all had their troubles and parted, we'll be the same as we started, just traveling along, singing a song, side by side, side by side.
Well, we sure are happy that you are all here.
We're two lost souls on the highway of life. We ain't even got a sister or brother, but ain't it just great? Ain't it just grand? We got each other. We're two lost ships on a stormy sea. One with no sail and one with no rudder, but ain't it just great? Ain't it just grand? We got each other wherever we go, whatever we do, as long as you've got me and I've got you, we got a lot, because we got each other.
So, Paul, what made you want to do a show with me?
Well, when we decided to call the show The Tall and Short of It, I knew I'd be the tall one. And you're so...
diminutive?
No.
Petite?
No.
Adorable?
Well, yes, but what I was looking for was... what I was looking for were contrasts. You know, Burns and Allen, Abbott and Costello, Laurel and Hardy.
Beauty and the Beast.
Yeah. Well, but, you know, I wanted someone who could keep up with me. You know, I'm as good as I ever was in my prime.
Okay.
Yeah. I can sing.
Uh-huh.
I can still announce.
Yes, you can.
I can dance.
Oh, really? Mambo!
Mambo!
Who's got the pain when they do the mambo? Who's got the pain when they go?
Oh.
Who's got the pain when they do the mambo? I know who. It's you.
Who needs a pill when they do the mambo? Who needs a pill when they go? Oh! Who needs a pill when they do the mambo? I don't know who.
It's you.
Someone must be sick with the heat
or stepping on everyone's feet. But if everyone's feeling okay, why don't they just say olé, olé. When the music carries them away? Who's got the pain when they do the mambo? Who's got the pain when they go, oh? Who's got the pain when they do the mambo? I know who, it's you. Is there a doctor in the house?
Is there a doctor in the house?
If there's a doctor in the house, a pointer out.
For there is an element of doubt as to who's got the pain when they do the mambo? Who's got the pain when they go, oh? Who's got the pain when they do the mambo?
Tall, mature, short-term memory loss. It's you.
Wherever we go, whatever we do, as long as you've got me and I've got you, we got a lot, because we got each other. Mambo! Well, it's great to be back here at the Metropolitan Room. I brought along a few favorite songs from last time, as well as several new ones, and a wonderful new partner, Dana Mierlak.
Yeah.
Here's what I want you to know. You're going to see a lot more of her later. Of course it's fun to wear a red paper hat. Of course it's nice to know the wine isn't flat. But if you take a certain comfort in that, you better have me there. The life of the party. Oh, of course.
It's nice to see
the streamers are flung.
Yeah.
That the guest list is appealingly young. But if you really want a bell really rung, you better have me there. The life of the party, oh no. You wouldn't want the night to be a bore, to have them gazing fondly at the door. So why not have the guarantee the fun's about to begin when I come sauntering in? Oh yes, it's nice to give them colorful lights or lovely ladies dressed in lavender tights. But if you wanna have the night of all nights, you better have me there. The life of the party, the life of the party, to bring every party to life. Well, many of you know that I'm the founder of the Big Apple Circus. There's another founder in here. Richard Levy is somewhere. Where are you, Richard? Raise your hand. Where's Richard? He's a founder of the Big Apple Circus as well. Right over there somewhere. Okay. So one day in my office, my phone rang, and it was Rhoda Dresnikoff. Rhoda Dresnikoff. She said she was Joe Layton's assistant. Now, Joe Layton was one of the biggest directors on Broadway. And she said, Joe is about to start a new musical, direct a new musical for Broadway called Barnum, and would I come to the first rehearsal so that I can help them create the circus parts from the show? Well, I played it cool, but inside I was Kermit the Frog. Yay! So we did it. The Big Apple Circus created all the circus parts for the hit musical Barnum, both here in New York, in London, the national tour in South Africa, and in Australia. Sasha Pavlotta taught Jim Dale how to walk a tight wire, and I personally taught Glenn Close how to juggle. She honored me by writing the foreword to my book, Never Quote the Weather to a Sea Lion, which is on sale at the gift shop. I'll sign a copy for you if you actually want a copy. We have some out there. So here's one of my favorite numbers from Barnum.
Barnum's the name, P.T. Barnum. Everything about my museum was spectacular, including the price, $1.
$1?
Well, that may seem like a bit much, but look what I gave him. Quite a lot of Roman terracotta, living lava from the flanks of Etna, statuary, ride a dromedary, see the temple tumble, and the Red Sea part. McNamara's band, the fattest lady in the land, a pickled prehistoric hand, a strand of Pocahontas hair. Crow and Suhul going to be showing you they're rowing through a model of the rapids on the Delaware. Armadillas, clever caterpillars, reproduction of the Cyclops retina, crystal blowing, automatic sewing, Venus on the shell, and other works of art. Educated fleas, a tribe of Aborigines, two ladies joined across the knees, a Mona Lisa made of ice, Hottentots we gotten in forgotten spots, a cotton gin, a night with Lot and Sodom. Better see that twice. One iguana, snakes another fauna, got no bearded lady, but we're getting a. When you duck out, take another buck out, run around the block and see a new show start. Quite a lot of Roman terracotta, living lava from the flanks of Etna, statuary, ride a dromedary, see the temple tumble in the Red Sea part. McNamara's band, the fattest lady in the land, a pickled prehistoric hand, a strand of Pocahontas hair, Crow and Sue are going to be rowing you, showing you they're rowing through a model of the rapids on the Delaware. Armadillas, clever caterpillars, reproduction of the Cyclops retina, crystal blowing, automatic sewing, Venus on the shell, and other works of art. Educated fleas, a tribe of Aborigines, two ladies joined across the knees, and a Mona Lisa made of ice. Hottentots we gotten in forgotten spots of cotton gin, a night with Lot and Sodom. Better see that twice. One iguana, snakes another pawna, got no bearded lady, but we're getting a. When you duck out, take another buck out, run around the block and see, and run around the block and see, and run around the block and see a new show start. What do you think, Joseph? I learned the words, didn't I? Yeah. So P.T. Barnum, actually, you know, he did present oddities, cultural oddities, but he also had an eye out for the most interesting acts from Europe. He was the Flo Ziegfeld from his of his day. He brought Jenny Lind to the United States, called her the Swedish Nightingale, bringing opera to the masses. Now, take a bow, Dennis Bach, stand up and take a bow. That's that man sitting right there at the keyboard conducted the national tour of Barnum. And here is the actual.
Oh, somebody saw it.
Yeah, go ahead. Somebody saw it. The actual introduction that he did for the show, this is how he introduced Jenny Lind. Ladies and gentlemen, Dennis Bach.
Ladies and gentlemen, Miss Lind thanks you for your kind reception to her performance and asks if she may sing one more song for you. It's a song she sang at her first concert in Sweden for King Gustav. She would like to perform it tonight in America for her very new friend, Mr. Barnum.
Love.
everybody. Now I get to say hello. Actually, I just want to take a moment to say thank you, everybody, for coming. Tonight's kind of a special night for me. This is my first time back on stage in New York in 2 years because of an accident I had. I was hit by a car, and I have wanted to thank everyone that's here because so many of you have supported me and through my recovery in the last 2 years, and this is just a really great thing for you all to be here for me. So thank you. Hi, Tom. So, I mean, as you all noticed, there are a few differences between me and Paul. One kind of obvious, he's from the world of the circus, and I'm from the world of music and theater. But just like the circus has changed and evolved over the years, so has music. When P.T. Barnum presented Jenny Lind, classical music was all the rage. As time went on and things changed and evolved, what we know now as Broadway belting became very popular, largely because of a woman that Paul and I adore. She is known to have once said, "I don't mean to imply that I..." What did she say? Dana, what did she say? She said, "I don't mean to imply that I discovered all the greatest songs of the 30s and 40s, just most of them." I'm, of course, talking of Miss Ethel Merman. Taking stock of what I have and what I haven't, what do I find? The things I've got will keep me satisfied. Checking up on what I have and what I haven't, what do I find? A healthy balance on the credit side. I got rhythm, I got music, I got my man, who could ask for anything more? I got daisies in green pastures, I got my man, who could ask for anything more? Old man trouble, I don't mind him, you won't find him round my front or back door. I got starlight, I got sweet dreams, I got my man, who could ask for anything more? Got no diamond, got no pearl, still I think I'm a lucky girl. I got the sun in the morning and the moon at night. Got no diamond, got no yacht, still I'm happy with what I got. I got the sun in the morning and the moon at night. Sunshine gives me a lovely day. Moonlight gives me the Milky Way.
There is one more Ethel Merman story.
You maybe know, you'll get it right.
She auditioned for George Gershwin. And somewhere in the middle of the audition, Gershwin said to her, "Miss Merman, have you ever had a singing lesson?" And she said, "No." And he said, "Well, don't. Stay just like you are." So here's another number that Merman did.
I hear singing, and there's no one there.
That's odd.
I smell blossoms, and the trees are bare.
That's just bizarre.
All day long, I seem to walk on air. I wonder why.
I wonder how.
I wonder why. I keep tossing in my sleep at night.
Toss, toss, mix, 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 toss, toss.
And what's more, I've lost my appetite.
That could work for me.
Stars that used to twinkle in the skies are twinkling in my eyes. I wonder why.
You don't need analyzing. It is not so surprising that you feel very strange but nice. Your heart goes pitter-patter. I know just what's the matter, because I've been there once or twice. Put your head on my shoulder.
You're too tall.
You need someone who's older. A love down with a velvet glove. There is nothing you can take to relieve that pleasant ache. You're not sick, you're just in love.
I
you don't
hear
need
singing
analyzing.
And there's
it
no
is
one
not
there.
So surprising
I
that you
smell
feel
blossoms
very strange,
in
but
the
nice.
Trees are there.
Heart
day
goes
long I
patter.
Seem to walk
I know just
on air.
What's
I
the matter
why.
Because I've been
I
there once or
why.
Twice.
I
put your
keep
head on
my
shoulder.
My
you need
at
someone
night.
Who's older.
And
rub
what's
down
more,
with a velvet
glove.
There is nothing you can take to relieve that pleasant ache. You're not sick,
eyes,
you're just in love. Look at all those friends out there. Go and talk with them, my dear.
I'm not sick.
You're
I'm just
in love. Ah. Now, some of you may be familiar with my sweetheart. My lover girl, yes, my dream girl, my roommate, my domestic partner, Shelley Dockers. She's actually Dr. Shelley Dockers, a clinical psychologist and psychoanalyst. Shelley gets invited to conferences all over the world, and somebody's got to carry her bags. So I've learned that when psychologists talk about patients, they assign them names to protect their identities. I'd like to tell you about one patient I learned about in particular. Let's call her Patient A. Patient A had been engaged to the same man for 14 years, and he was a professional gambler. And at all that time, 14 years, he never once set a wedding date. Out of frustration and desperation, Patient A decided to turn to psychology for help. So allow me to read from this book, Towards an Emancipatory Psychoanalysis by, amongst others, Dr. Shelley Dockers. It says here, the average unmarried female, basically insecure, due to some long frustration, may react with psychosomatic symptoms difficult to endure, affecting the upper respiratory tract. Patient A. In other words, just from we're just waiting around for that plain little band of gold. A person can develop a cold. You can spray her wherever you figure the streptococci like. You can give her a shot for whatever she's got, but it just won't work. If she's tired of getting the fisheye from the hotel clerk, a person can develop a cold. It says here, the female remaining single, just in the legal sense, shows a neurotic tendency, see note, chronic organic symptoms, toxic or hypertense, involving the eye, the ear, the nose, and throat. Patient A. In other words, just from wondering whether the wedding is on or off, a person can develop a cough. You can feed her all day with the vitamin A and the bromo fizz, but the medicine never gets anywhere near where the trouble is. If she's getting a kind of a name for herself and the name ain't his, her bison can develop a cough. And furthermore, just from stalling and stalling and stalling the wedding trip, a bison can develop la grippe. When they get on the train for Niagara, she can hear church bells chime. The compartment is air-conditioned and the mood sublime. Then they get off at Saratoga for the 14th time. A bison can develop la grippe, la grippe, like post-nasal drip, with the wheezes and the sneezes and a sinus that's really a pip. From the lack of community property and a feeling she's getting too old, a person can develop a bad, bad cold. Ah, shoot! Let's see then. Oh, yeah. So Dennis and Dana and I were invited at the beginning of October to sing at an international psychoanalytic convention. Truth. This is the truth. And this is a song that Dennis chose to sing. From the Bible to the popular song, there's one theme that we find all along. Of all the traits that are hailed as good, the most sublime is motherhood.
There was a man, though, who it seems once carried this idea to extremes. He loved his mother and she loved him. And yet his story is rather grim.
There once lived a man named Oedipus Rex. You may have heard about his odd complex. His name appears in Freud's index, 'cause he loved his mother.
His rivals used to say quite a bit that as a monarch he was most unfit. But still and all, they had to admit that he loved his mother.
Yes, he loved his mother like no other. His daughter was his sister and his son was his brother. One thing on which you can depend is he sure knew who a boy's best friend is. When he saw what he had done, he plucked out his eyes one by one.
A tragic end to a loyal son who
loved his mother.
Here comes the moral. So be sweet and kind to mother. Now and then have a chat. Buy her candy or some flowers or a brand new hat. But perhaps you had better leave it just at that.
Or you might find yourself with a quite complex complex.
And you may end up like Oedipus.
I'd rather marry a duck-billed platypus
than end up like old Oedipus Rex.
Well, the next song was written in the 1970s, and it was written for the movie The Little Shop of Horrors, which is a story that's set in the 1950s, and it features a character named Audrey, who is in love with Seymour and dreams of escaping Skid Row with him.
Matchbox of our own, a fence of real chain link, A grill out on the patio, dispose all in the sink. A washer and a dryer and an ironing machine. In a tract house that we'll share somewhere that's green. He rakes and trims the grass. He loves to mow and weed. I cook like Betty Crocker, and I look like Donna Reed. There's plastic on the furniture to keep it neat and clean. In the pine salt-scented air, somewhere that's green. Between our frozen dinners and our bedtime, 9:15, we snuggle watching Lucy on our big, enormous 12-inch screen. I'm his December bride. He's father, he knows best. Our kids watch Howdy Doody as the sun sets in the west. A picture out of Better Homes and Gardens magazine. Far from Skid Row, I dream we'll go somewhere that's green.
That song was written by the great Alan Menken.
Alan Menken and his lyricist Howard Ashman wrote the scores to many soundtracks for Disney, which later became Broadway shows, such as Aladdin, Beauty and the Beast, and The Little Mermaid. The next song was written by a great Tin Pan Alley songwriter, the one and only Irving Berlin, you guessed it. It was featured in one of the great musical hits of all time, Easter Parade.
Couple of swells, we stop at the best hotels, but we prefer the country far away from the city smells.
We're a couple of sports, the pride of the tennis courts. In June, July, and August, we look cute when we're dressed in shorts.
The Vanderbilts have asked us up for tea.
We don't know how to get there, no siree,
no siree. We would drive up the avenue, but we haven't got the price. We would skate up the avenue, but there isn't any ice. We would ride on a bicycle, but we haven't got a bike. So we'll walk up the avenue, yes, we'll walk up the avenue. And to walk up the avenue's what we like.
Wall Street bankers are we, with plenty of currency.
We'd open up the safe, but we forgot where we put the key.
We're the favorite lads of the girls in the picture ads.
We'd like to tell you who we kissed last night, but we can't be cads.
The Vanderbilts are waiting at the club.
But how are we to get there? That's the rub.
That's the rub. We would sail up the avenue, but we haven't got a yacht.
we would drive up the avenue, but the horse we had was shot. We would ride on a trolley car, but we haven't got the fare. So we'll walk up the avenue, yes, we'll walk up the avenue, yes, we'll walk up the avenue till we're there. So we'll walk up the avenue, yes, we'll walk up the avenue, yes, we'll walk up the avenue till we're there.
So I was born and raised in Brooklyn. I'm not talking about $6 million condo Brooklyn of today. I'm talking about deep Brooklyn, Flatbush, near Sheepshead Bay. And the most famous person to come out of our neighborhood was David Daniel Kaminsky. Danny Kaye. That's who said that? Did somebody say that? Oh, good. Danny Kaye. Now, we kids just adored Danny Kaye. Our parents would ask us to do our homework, and we'd say, don't have to. Danny Kaye never finished high school. Well, when I was 10 years old, I had a dream come true. My parents took me to see Danny Kaye at the Palace. Here's the song he sang. It was written by the great Sylvia Fine about a man from humble circumstances who became one of the most celebrated people in all of Paris. It all began when I was born. A month too soon. My ma was frightened by a runaway saloon. Pa was forced to be a hobo because he played the oboe, and the oboe, it is clearly understood, is an ill wind that no one blows good. I'll never forget the morning that Grandpa ate the awning to impress a pretty lady who went for men that were shady. And Uncle Josiah lit the great Frisco fire, ran off to Hawaii with the O'Leary cow, which his loving wife resented, and thereupon invented a rolling pin that strikes and then says pow. And I'm the result of those twisted eugenics of a family of inbred schizophrenics, the end of a long, long line of bats. I design women's hats. I'm Anatole of Paris. I shriek with chic. My hat of the week caused 6 divorces, 3 runaway horses. Let me get my paw on a little piece of straw. Et voila! Un chapeau at $1,000 a throw. It's how I pull and chew on it, the little things I do on it, like placing yards of lacing or a bicycle bill for two on it. The one called Whiskey Sour, designed for the cocktail hour. A little snip of potato chip and a trifle of the Eiffel Tower. I'm Anatole of Paris, I must design. I am like wine, I go to the head. Give me thread and a needle. I itch, I twitch to stitch. I'm a glutton for cutting, for pushing on a button. And tote that barge, lift that veil. And why do I sew each new chapeau with a style that look positively grim in? Strictly between us, entre nous, I love women. So when I was 7 years old, my parents took me to my first Broadway show. It was Where's Charlie? It was based on the play Charlie's Aunt. Charlie's Aunt, from Brazil, where the nuts come from. And both Charlie and Charlie's Aunt were played by Ray Bolger, who I had grown up with, seeing as the Scarecrow in The Wizard of Oz. Well, one moment in that show, one particular moment, Ray Bolger stepped to the front of the stage. This is a moment I shall never forget. Left a big impression on me, I'm sure. It's why I wanted to be in show business. He stepped to the front of the stage, he sang, and he danced, and then he asked all of us to sing along with him. I tell you, to this day, I have the clearest memory of that song. Maybe we'll do it this time. I caught you, sir, having a look at her as she went strolling by. And didn't your heart go boom, ba, boom, ba, boom? And didn't you sigh, a sigh? I warned you, sir, never to dream of her. Just bid such thoughts be gone. Or it'll be boom, 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 ba, boom, ba, boom, ba, 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 boom. From then on, for once in love with Amy. Always in love with Amy. Ever and ever fascinated by her, sets your heart afire to stay. Once you're kissed by Amy, tear up your list, it's Amy. Ply her with bonbons, poetry and flowers, moon a million hours away. You might be quite the fickle-hearted rover, so carefree and bold, who loves a girl and later thinks it over, then just quits cold. But once in love with Amy, always in love with Amy, ever sweetly you'll romance her. Trouble is her answer will be ha 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 ha. Let Amy rather stay in love with me. Well, I love this song so much, I want everybody to sing along with me. Now, for those of you who are under 70, don't worry, I'll give you the words. We can all sing along. Dana, why don't you come on in here and help us out? I don't even know where she is. Oh, there she is. Good. Okay, here we go. Ready, everybody? Once in love with Amy.
Once in love.
Always in love with Amy.
Always in love with Amy.
Ever and ever fascinated by her.
Ever and ever.
Set your heart afire to stay.
Set your heart on fire to stay.
Very good. Here we go. Once in love with Amy.
Once in love.
Always in love with Amy.
Always in love.
Ever and ever, sweetly
Amy.
You'll romance her.
Ever and ever.
Trouble as her answer will be. Ha ha ha.
Trouble is her answer will be. Ha, ha, ha.
No, no, wait, 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 wait. Stop. Hold up. Hee haw. Whoa, whoa. This is the moment in the song. Trouble is her answer will be. Ha 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 ha. So let's give it a try. One, two, three.
Ha, 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 ha.
I think we've got it. Here we go. Once in love with Amy.
Once in love with Amy.
Always in love with Amy.
Always in love.
Ever and ever,
with
sweetly
Amy.
You'll romance her.
Ever and ever.
Trouble is her answer will be ha 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 ha.
Trouble is her answer will be ha ha ha.
Let Amy rather stay in love with me. Thank you. You were terrific.
I have a little rearranging to do. It may not look like it, but Paul and I actually do have a couple of things in common. One of them is that we were both 7 years old when we saw our first Broadway show. Mind you, mine was 1987 and his was 1947, but who's counting? Regardless, we were both very much inspired by our first Broadway shows and clearly bitten by that showbiz bug. In fact, when I was a kid, my uncles took me and my sister to see Paul, well, not to see Paul, but to see the Big Apple Circus. And Paul was the wonderful ringmaster at the time, so it's kind of cool, right? About 16 years or so after that first Broadway show, I decided to follow my dream, and I moved into my first New York City apartment.
calm and peaceful. Heaven for a mouse like me, with quiet by the leaseful. Pets are banned, and parties too, and no solicitations. Window seat with garden view, a perfect nook to read a book. I'm lost in my Jane Austen when I hear. Say it isn't so, not the flat blow from an opera wannabe in 13G, the matinee of some cantata, Wagner's Ring or Traviata.
Circus set up its first big top on a landfill in Battery Park City. Try to remember the kind of September when life was slow and oh so mellow. Try to remember the kind of September when grass was green and grain was yellow. Try to remember when life was so tender and you were a tender and callow fellow. Try to remember, and if you remember, then follow. 2 years later, we set up at Lincoln Center with the Metropolitan Opera on one side, the New York City Ballet on the other. Hey, Ma, look at me now. Try to remember when life was so tender, when no one wept except the willow. Try to remember when life was so tender that dreams were kept beside your pillow. Try to remember when life was so tender that love was an ember about to billow. Try to remember, and if you remember, then follow. Well, we had a hell of a run. 38 years. And now they tell me it's over. Deep in December, it's nice to remember. Although you know the snow will follow. Deep in December, it's nice to remember, without a hurt, the heart is hollow. Deep in December, it's nice to remember, the fire of September that made us mellow. Deep in December, our hearts should remember and follow.
At words poetic, I'm so pathetic that I always have found it best, instead of getting them off my chest, to let him rest unexpressed. I hate parading my serenading, as I'll probably miss a bar. But if this ditty is not so pretty, at least it'll tell you how great you are. You're the top, you're the Colosseum, you're the top, you're the Louvre Museum, you're a melody from a symphony by Strauss,
you're a Bendel Bonnet,
a Shakespeare sonnet,
you're Mickey Mouse.
Is that a short joke?
You're the Nile, you're the Tower of Pisa, you're the smile on the Mona Lisa. I'm a worthless check, a total wreck, a flop, but if baby I'm the bottom, you're the top.
You're the top, you're Mahatma Gandhi,
you're the top, you're Napoleon Brandy,
you're the purple light of a summer night in Spain,
you're the National Gallery,
you're Garbo's salary,
you're cellophane,
you're sublime, you're a turkey dinner,
turkey, you're the time of the Derby winner.
I'm a toy balloon that's faded soon to pop, but if baby I'm the bottom, you're the top.
You're the top, you're a Waldorf salad, you're the top, you're a Berlin ballad,
you're the nimble tread of the feet of Fred Astaire, you're an O'Neill drama,
you're Whistler's mama,
you're Camembert
cheese,
yeah, stinky cheese. Ooh. You're a rose, you're Inferno's Dante,
you're the nose on the Great Durante. I'm a lazy lout who's just about to stop, but if baby I'm the bottom, you're the top.
You're the top, you're a dancing Bali,
you're the top, you're a hot tamale.
You're an angel, you simply too divine.
You're Keats.
You're Botticelli.
You're Keats.
You're Shelley.
No, she's out there.
Hi, Shelley.
You're Ovaltine. You're Moon. You're the damn it boulder.
You're the moon over May West Shore.
I'm a frightened frog who can find no log to hop. But if baby, I'm the bottom.
But if baby, I'm the bottom.
But if baby, I'm the bottom, you're the top. Thank you. Well, I want to thank a whole bunch of people, Bernie and Joanne Fershban and Joseph Macchia and the entire crew here at the Metropolitan Room. Woo-hoo! Remember to take good care of your waiters. They've taken good care of you. And a big thank you to our technical director, the guy behind the screen over there, Jean-Pierre Perrault. The window, right? And Dennis Buck at the keyboard.
Dennis!
And what do you think of Dana Mierlak?
Mention my name in Sheboygan. It's the greatest little town in the world. Just tell them you're an old friend of mine, and every door in town will have a big welcome sign. So mention my name in Sheboygan, and if you ever get in a jam, just mention my name. I said mention my name, but please don't tell them where I am.
Take it, Dennis.
Oh, mention my name in Paducah.
Paducah.
It's the greatest little town in the world.
Sing it, Dennis.
I know a gal there you'll simply adore. She was Miss Paducah back in 1904. So mention my name in Paducah.
Paducah.
And if you ever get in a mess, just mention my name. I said mention my name, but please don't give her my address.
Take it, Dana.
Mention my name in Elmira.
Elmira.
It's the greatest little town in the world. I told the mayor that he would go far. I even gave the sheriff an exploding cigar. So mention my name in Elmira. And if they happen to put you in jail, just mention my name. I said mention my name, but please don't write to me for bail.
Mention my name in Tacoma.
Tacoma.
It's the greatest little town in the world. I know the big shots in City Hall. They even got my picture on the post office wall.
So mention my name in Tacoma.
It's the greatest little head in the jam. If you ever get a spat,
mention my name. I said mention my name, but please don't tell them where I'm at.
It ain't no Joyzy.
Please don't tell them where I'm at.
Forget the Hamptons.
Please don't tell them where I'm at.
Not even Flatbush.
Please don't tell them where I'm at.
Ladies and gentlemen, Paul Binder, Dana Mierlak. Dennis Buck.
And they've all had their troubles and parted. We'll be the same as we started. Just traveling along, singing a song, side by side.
Thank you.
You don't do anything else.
We are ill prepared.
You don't do anything else.
We don't have an encore, guys. That was it. Okay.
Oh, we ain't got a barrel of money. Maybe we're ragged and funny, but we'll travel along, singing a song side by side. Though we don't know what's coming tomorrow or right now.
Maybe it's trouble and sorrow,
but we'll travel the road, sharing our load side by side. Just as long as we're together, it really doesn't matter at all. When they've all had their troubles and parted, we'll be the same as we started. Just traveling along, singing a song, side by side.
Ladies and gentlemen, Paul Binder, John O'Mara.